David Pogue has been future-gazing all this month, looking into the brave new world of artificial intelligence. This morning, he explains why with AI, seeing isn't always believing.
I'm going to show you some magic.
That's not Tom Cruise.
It's the real thing.
Я змушений приймати складні рішення.
That's not the Ukrainian president calling for his citizens to surrender.
We're entering an era in which our enemies can make it look like anyone is saying anything at any point in time.
And that's a fake Obama. Although what he's saying here is true. These are deepfakes, phony videos of real people, generated by artificial intelligence software at the hands of people who want to undermine our trust. These days, deepfakes are becoming so realistic that experts worry about what they'll do to news and democracy.
Now hold on. This is not going to be one of those depressing news stories. This story is about how the good guys are fighting back.
How can we solve this problem? Is there a way out?
Eric Horvitz is Microsoft's chief scientific officer and the co-creator of the email spam filter. 2 years ago, he began trying to solve this problem.
Within 5 or 10 years, if we don't have this technology, most of what people will be seeing, or quite a lot of it, will be synthetic. We won't be able to tell the difference.
Yeah, look at that.
As it turned out, a similar effort was underway at Adobe, the company that makes Photoshop.
So we wanted to think about giving everyone a tool, a way to tell whether something's true or not.
Dana Rao is Adobe's chief counsel and chief trust officer.
Why not just have your genius engineers develop some software program that can analyze a video and go, beep, that's a fake?
Problem is, the technology to detect AI is developing, and the technology to edit AI is developing, and there's always going to be this horse race of which one wins. And so we know that for a long-term perspective, AI is not going to be the answer.
My fellow Americans.
Both companies concluded that trying to distinguish real videos from phony ones would be a never-ending arms race.
And we flipped the problem on its head because we said, what we really need is to provide people a way to know what's true instead of trying to catch everything that's false.
So you're not out to develop technology that can prove that something's a fake. This technology will prove that something's for real.
That's exactly what we're trying to do. It is a lie detector for photos and videos.
Eventually, Microsoft and Adobe joined forces and designed a new feature called Content Credentials, which they hope will someday appear on every authentic photo and video. Here's how it works.
Imagine you're scrolling through your social feed. Someone sent you a picture of snowy pyramids, and they told you that the scientists found them in Antarctica. And you're like, well, I don't remember that from my fifth grade English class. Let me click on this button here, and you can take a look for yourself. You can see the original, and you can see the new image that you've seen.
That little button reveals the history of this photo or video, its content credentials.
You can see who took it, when they took it, and where they took it, and the edits that were made.
And if that little button in the top right isn't there, then what do I conclude?
You would say, I think this person may be trying to fool me.
Already, 900 companies have agreed to display the content credentials button. They represent the entire life cycle of photos and videos, from the camera that takes them to the websites that display them.
The bad actors, they're not going to use this tool. They're going to try and fool you, and they're going to make up something. Why didn't they want to show me their work? Why didn't they want to show me what was real, what edits they made? Because if they didn't want to show that to you, maybe you shouldn't believe them.
Now, content credentials aren't going to be a silver bullet. We're also going to need laws, and we're also going to need education so that we, the people, can fine-tune our baloney detectors.
But in the next couple of years, you'll start seeing that special button on photos and videos online. At least on the ones that aren't fake.
We're trying out different prototypes right now. If someone tampers with that video, in this case a gold symbol comes up and says, content credentials incomplete.
Aha.
Step back, be skeptical.
Wow, so as a person on the viewing end, I don't need to know about all your complicated manifest Microsoft mumbo jumbo. I just see either that icon's there or it's missing or indicating that something's wrong.
Absolutely.
You're mentioning media companies, New York Times, BBC, you're mentioning software companies, Microsoft, Adobe, who are in some realms competitors. You're saying that they all lay down their arms to work together on something to save democracy.
Yeah, I think that groups working together across the larger ecosystem, social media platforms, computing platforms, broadcasters, producers, and governments.
Wow, so this thing could work.
I think it has a chance of making a dent, potentially a big dent in the challenges we face and us all coming together in a way to address this challenge of our time.
If you like what you're seeing, just wait till what's coming next.